They weren't on the bike.
I suppose you are. Well, welcome to Titans. Is your group all from the same area? We're missing 54 Titan II vessel sites. This is the only one left. The others have all been destroyed, imploded, filled in, but no existence today. So if your minds go back about 35, 40 years ago when this site was operational, you come out here at that time, the only thing you would have seen had been that outside perimeter fence through these power poles that's out of Air Force Base here in Tucson. They bring it out, use it, then return it to the base. When this became a museum, it was able to obtain that equipment, put it on display so you can see what it looks like. By the way, I see cameras.
Large gray thrust ring around it. Now that thrust ring is suspended on four springs. Each one of those is about three stories high.
Keep that noise and vibration within limits. Now in the movie, you saw the launch of the missile. Those booms come out of sight. The majority of those crew members. Here's the terminus and controls for all that communications at 10 of, we talked about topside, responsibility of the commander, who's also responsible for safety, keeping track of anyone on the site, someone out there servicing the missile, keeping constant communication with them, and of course he's always responsible. State of the art. Well, the system was designed to last for about 10 years. After that time, the Air Force said, we're keeping it around. Well, they had major problems by then. Obsolete technology, lack of spare parts. However, MIT, working in conjunction with Delta Electronics, had devised a universal space guidance system. Now, they adapted that. The Titan II system chucked almost 19 pounds at the half of this one.
Wow.
You probably got more computer power in your cameras today than that has. But that was more than anybody else had. 3, 2, 1, launch, turn, hold, all the way. 4, 3, 2, 1, thank you. Now, do now. You start a sequence that cannot be stopped. Like pulling the trigger on a rifle. You've got a launch enable light. Means you have a good butterfly valve lock. You have a battery activated light. You have two onboard 28 volt batteries being 4% electrolyte. First time you had it, 28 seconds are going to be at the full power. Then you get your APS light, auxiliary power light. Now this will indicate that that missile is now on its own power, no longer depend upon this complex. You're going to get a silo soft light. See that big 760 ton silo closure door is opening. You can't see it, feel it, or hear it. But the best place to sit is set off that alarm, lets you know it's open. Commanders usually don't know. Now you have a giant scope, which means that you have propellants coming together out there in the silo. You have ignition, there's fire, water pouring, fire, steam. Of course, all that sets off. Fire warning lights out there in the silo. Power comes up to 77%, explosive bolts release, and then we have liftoff. 58 seconds of time you turn this key to you have liftoff. You notice we do not have an oops button here. You cannot stop that missile, you cannot divert it, you cannot destroy it, because if we had that capability, you had to assume our adversaries would. Did not want that coming back at us. Now, 30 to 35 minutes from now, assuming a range of approximately 6,000 miles, target 2 is going to cease to exist.